Exard here, and if you're wondering about my uploading schedule, don't worry that I'll make one once I'm done with school. I have, what, 2 more weeks, and then finals, although I'll probably be able to put up videos during finals because I don't have any hard ones, just projects beforehand. So yeah, uploads slow, but today I have my Anything Goes tour games. This is round two in Best of Three Anything Goes tour versus Rosie Bear. Round one wasn't really too interesting. I felt Lax Lapras, who is a good player, good OM player, but does... Remind me to turn off Discord. Anyway, doesn't really play Anything Goes, stole some teams I won, wasn't too interesting, but this is a pretty interesting series. So, game one, Rosie Bear brings 5 Arceus and a Rayquaza, and I'm like, yeah, I love Anything Goes. I really do. So, you're seeing that over half of the Pokemon right now are Arceus. We got another 2 Rayquaza, and then, you know, a couple other things. Dialga isn't really too common. This is a team that I'm having a lot of fun with. It's a Calm Mind, Arceus Fairy, and then Darkrai, Scarf Dialga, which is just, it's nice to have a fast extreme speed resist. And if you're going to say, use Scarf Genesect or Scarf Jirachi, Scarf Genesect is awful. Scarf Jirachi is okay, but it's not that great. It takes too much from extreme speed for one. Scarf Dialga is a pretty cool mon. And then Arceus Poison makes me not auto lose to Xerneas. I have Swords Dance Rayquaza because I was a little weak to stall and stuff. And slept down a defensive Yveltal. Arceus spam is an okay matchup for this team. Yveltal is annoying. The problem is you gotta make sure you don't get caught by one with Stone Edge. But then I also have Scarf Dialga to check. Rayquaza can annoy them. Poison Seas is Roar. It's physically defensive with Roar, so I can generally play the matchup decently. Leading off, I actually throw out Dialga because I... Never mind. That was round one that I threw out Dialga and I forgot it was Scarfed. Turn one, he's actually going to Swords Dance with Arceus Steel, which just isn't a great set, so I didn't really expect it, but he's Swords Dance Earthquake. I'm just going to roll him out. I know I can take any one hit, so it's fine. As he brings in Rayquaza. I do want to save Arceus Poison, just sort of scouting out his team, and I do have an Arceus Fairy, which is a perfectly fine switch into Rayquaza, unless, of course, you get crit. It's fine, like, I can live the hit, I can recover next turn, but, I don't know, a little bit annoying. Turn one doesn't really matter. He's gonna go right back into Arceus Steel as I recover, and, I just didn't want to risk anything. I probably could have gone Yveltal, but I go right to Arceus Poison. Maybe not the best play, but it doesn't really matter. The chances of him having a Phariseus on what looks like Arceus spam, I thought was pretty low at this point, so I'm gonna go right to Darkrai. He's actually gonna choose the Sleep Fodder and Arceus Ghost. So he does have a Ghosteus. It's a bit of an interesting choice because it just gets hardwalled by Yveltal, which is definitely a huge threat to Arceus spam. But now we can go to the Rayquaza, which is at least gonna stop this Darkrai from being too threatening. Darkrai is just one of the best ways to handle Arceus spam because if it's typed, then you can't have an item, so then you can start screwing around with mons that don't commonly run Magikoat, Sleep Talk, or Lumberry. And that's very nice for Darkrai. Like, you can get checked by Arceus, but once you get in on one of the typed forms, you're cool. So I'm going to take out the Rayquaza, just sort of deal with it now, as he chooses to choose Arceus Normal, which, you know, I have to assume it's going to be Lum and stuff, got to switch out. Yveltal is fine at this point. I don't have, I can't tell which one's Stone Edge, and he's already revealed what most of his forms are, so I'm not gonna need Yveltal to check multiple, extreme killers. But here's very interesting, because he goes into Arceus Water, and until this point I was assuming, okay, he's got a Mega Rayquaza, he's got what I have to assume to be Swords Dance Arceus Normal, Swords Dance Arceus Ghost, and a Swords Dance Arceus Steel. This is all pretty regular, but he actually goes into a defensive Arceus Water, which tells me this is gonna be a little bit off-kilter Arceus spam. If the last one was Arceus Fairy, I would have been kind of screwed. I sacked Poison Seas, assuming that he didn't have an Arceus Fairy, and if it turned out to be that, then this game would have gotten a hell of a lot more interesting, more difficult for me. But yeah, he goes Arceus Water, which I just didn't expect. I'm gonna go right to Darkrai, because I'm pretty sure he's just gonna defog, get rid of the rocks, and yay, it's a free Dark Void. That's just what Darkrai does. Miss and get KO'd by Judgment. You know, that's Darkrai for you. Anything Goes has a lot of luck, and That's just part of it. Can't do much about it. I'm going to go right to Rayquaza. Because he's Judgment and Defog, he's not going to be Ice Beam, so I can pretty freely set up a Sword Stance, but he's going to reveal his last Arceus. His Arceus Dragon. Another just very interesting pick, so it's not really the standard Arceus spam. He's actually running two support forms, which is pretty interesting. In any case, I don't want to let Raid die, so I'm going to go right into Arceus Fairy. He still does have Arceus Steel, which I should have Earth Powered, because why the hell would he stay in? But I just click Judgment. Not really the best play I could have made, but I can go right out to Yveltal, because it still walls this. It's a Swords Dance form, and I have to assume it's Iron Head, Extreme Speed, Earthquake, but he's actually running Stone Edge and no Extreme Speed, which is really uncommon, but the fact that I didn't U-turn breaking him a switch is basically going to make all the difference in this game, because Arceus Steel, it checked Swords Dance my Rayquaza, it was his stop to Phariseus, and Scarf Dialga has, Flash Cannon, Draco Meteor, both resisted, so I'd have to predict it go for Fire Blast. So because he sacked it, that's going to turn what could have been a... I think I still would have won, just because Rayquaza plus Yveltal is just going to put a lot of pressure on his team. But he's going to let this go down to a foul play just to take out Yveltal, and that's going to make all the difference, because at this point, he lost the Mon that was really just stopping me from winning. And he goes to Normal Zeus, which just can't KO with an Extreme Speed, because Yveltal is kind of disgusting. And Jolly Lum E-Killer is it's still the best set, because Darkrai, because you kind of need Jolly, but it's weak as shit, and everyone knows it. But yeah, defensive Yveltal is just going to pull through right there. Does a lot to Dragon Zeus. I think just U-turn. No, okay, I go right down to Fairy Zeus. He's going to predict that going to Water Zeus. I'm just going to Calm Mind. He misses Toxic. And as I Judgment for the 2 KO, he's actually going to miss Toxic again. But once he, once the Steel Seas was gone, all I needed was just Calm Mind twice, start KO something with this, and then get Rayquaza in. So I think it was kind of over from there. Still kind of unfortunate as he goes into Arceus Normal. That's not going to KO me at plus 2, and it's going to get 2 KO'd. Arceus Fairy, just a very solid Mon. It can take... a plus one Dragon Ascent in Oko Mega Rayquaza, and that automatically makes it decent. And from there, you also Calm Mind says it's just a great Mon. Doesn't get any love in Ubers, because you can only run one Arceus set, so why are you wasting your slot on something that can be done by Xerneas? But very cool Mon. He actually reveals he's actually Fire Blast Arceus Ghost, which is on Arceus spam, I guess, lures things like Ferrothorn and Skarmory. Pretty interesting, though, because you normally see that on the Arceus Normal, not the Arceus Ghost. Anyway, game two. This game isn't really good. I guess I'll just say that. I decided if I win game one, I'm bringing memes. I am bringing Lay Top Haha Funny Maymays. And in this case, is the team built around a special Mega Salamence, just because I can. And the game ends up sucking. I actually get the epic Shadow Ball predict. I was actually trying to catch a Fire Blast, but whatever. Shadow Ball Mewtwo is kind of stupid. And the reason this game is going to suck so much is that this team actually just has absolutely zero. Like, my checks to Rock Polish Primal Groudon is just Salamence, and that commonly carries Stone Edge or Dragon Claw. And there's going to be diddly piss I can do about this Primal Groudon. Like, my two remaining forms are Rock and Poison, just so you know. So I'm just going to kind of let this play out. He does have two Groudon, so I'm going to see. This one is Support. Actually takes not too much from that, because Spidef Groudon is dumb, and Special Mega Salamence is not good, and don't use it. But I was like, yeah, Maymays, I love Maymays. But I do let Salamence get weakened, because the Dawn lives on one. From that point, all it takes is for him to get in his Rock Polish one and kind of just win the game. I think that's going to happen now. Like, I switch out, just not really sure what to... Yeah, I go right to Mence. He Rock Polishes up, and that's the game right there. And I mean that totally seriously. Like, my win condition, I go to my Groudon first, because I wasn't sure if it was support or offensive. And it's offensive, and I just die, you know. My win condition would have had to be flinching him, and then somehow pulling this out with Arceus Rock, which isn't impossible, just because Arceus Rock checks two things, and Xerneas checks the other one. He's actually even going to miss a Precipice Blade, so I thought for a sec I might have had a chance, but nah. Now, it's taken a lot to flinch and dodge my way through that, and I'm not going to get that, so I get rightfully punished for bringing memes, and that's going to give an excuse for game 3, which is actually going to be a good game. So game 3, I bring this team, which is basically built around the core of Sword Dance, Arceus Ground, and either Rock Polish or Dual Dance. I think it's Dual Dance Primal Groudon, which is pretty cool. I know in Ubers, I mean, I keep comparing AG to Ubers, but that's because what a lot of people's knowledge of AG has to be based on. I know in Ubers, Double Ground is seen as a stupid core, but again, you have multiple Arceus forms. You can do what you want. So, what you have here is that normally people's ground checks, for offense, it's Mega Rayquaza. And for, like, balance and shit, it's gonna have to be a bulky Arceus form, like Arceus Water, or a Yveltal. And all that can be worn down by Sword Dance Primal Groudon for eventual Ground Sea Sweep. It's just, I found to be a very strong core. Because people just don't prepare for it too much. Excuse me, that's just my headset being bumped around a little bit. Anyway, people don't prepare for it too much. It's very nice. And I also have a Toxic Mega Diancie instead of Protect, which is basically just for luring in the bulky Arceus forms that get annoyed. I don't recommend the set at all. It's kind of stupid, and I should change that, really. But, yeah, that's that. And then I have Skarmory, because my team is also weak to ground. Then I have a Giratina O, because then I'm really weak to opposing Primal Groudon. And then, because I have no originalness at all, I slapped on Arceus, which I think is also poison. Because I wanted more Xerneas checks, you know. You know, that Geomancy mon that people underrate all the time. And the scarf set that people don't really think about enough. So, looking at Team Preview, we're both going to be pretty threatened by dual Groudon cores. Giratina kind of can get, like, worn down by one, and then Rock Polish is a problem, but on his side, his only ground check is Mega Ray, and then after that, my grounds are looking pretty good. He did bring the same team from last time, so I do know that it's some sort of weird Mewtwo set. I don't really know. It had, like, Shadow Ball. It's Scarf Xerneas. One Groudon is support, one Groudon's Rock Polish. Don't know the Ray set, but it's a Ray. Like, what is it going to do? And then, if I remember correctly, that is E-Killer? I actually forgot just now. I should know that. Anyway, it doesn't really matter. I'm going to lead off with Diancie, because it really doesn't do too much, and I was hoping, I don't know, catch something. But he leads Mewtwo, which is fine. Mewtwo is just generally annoying to switch into. For, like, anything, ever. It's just hard to switch into. So, I'm going to get off some chip damage, go right into Skarmory, just because he's probably going to Side Strike again. Skarmory seems safe, but I do need Skarmory. Right, because that's an E-Killer in the back. It's an Extreme Killer Arceus. I go to Giratina, expecting a Fire Blast. It's actually Thunder, which is pretty interesting. And then, unfortunately, he leaves the Sneak on one, which ends up really, really sucking. This is actually special Giratina. It's specially biased. Draco Meteor, Shadow Ball, Shadow Sneak, Dragon Tail, which is an original set thing I came up with. It's actually kind of solid. I expected it to suck and I'd go back to physical, but I kind of liked it, so I left it. Unfortunately, this is where it kind of sucks, because he lives that on one, and this was supposed to be my Rock Polish Groudon stop, and instead it's going to get Shadow Balled to the face. Like, it's still alive, but that kind of sucks. I'm just going to sneak again, as fortunately he sacks Mewtwo. I think saving it probably would have been the better play, but he didn't have a great switch in anyways. He goes right to Xerneas. I can just save Giratina, and I sack Diancie, kind of forgetting that my Arceus was poisoned, so I misplayed twice a bit, which is, you know, oh well. Diancie was doing absolutely nothing this game anyway, it doesn't matter, and this is a chance for me to get up my Stealth Rock, or double into Giratina, because I was predicting his Groudon, and I didn't want to have to switch into that. I can get up Stealth Rock later anyway, because he still has the Xerneas, so I'm going to get off a solid Draco Meteor on the support Groudon. Make that less of a threat. He's gonna lava plume me as I just drop another Draco, get off some damage, and this time he saves his like 2% thing and swaps out into the E-Killers. I'm not predicting that. If he wants to get in his Arceus, that's totally fine. I don't need Giratina at this point. It's weakened the Groudon, it took out the Mewtwo. Job well done, in my opinion. Plus, I can go right into the Skarmory, which totally walls this thing. I also want to recover up, keep it healthy for all his stuff. No, okay. See, I'm getting all mixed up. The reason I can get up rocks is because I have rocks on Skarmory. Normally what I do is I run rocks on Arceus Poison, and then on Skarmory I fit on Counter or Spikes. That's what I like to do. But this team I switched around a bit because it's way earlier. This is an old team that I still like to use, but it's a lot older than my other stuff. I haven't really updated it. So it's like full support Arceus Poison without Stealth Rock, and then Stealth Rock Skarmory. Okay, so I can go right into Arceus Poison because I know he's going to want to Lava Plume the Skarmory, and I can take that without really risking Precipice Blades and just take him out with a Poison Jab. So here, I'm looking pretty good. He hasn't really let his Mega Ray be weakened yet, but he goes into Arceus and Swords Dances, as I am going to reveal I'm Roar Set, and I pull him out to Rayquaza, get some nice Stealth Rock chip damage. I know he's seen Roar, he's not going to want to set up, he's just going to want to go right for the Ascent, but fortunately, I'm physically defensive, I take that easily, I take less than 50%, and I get off the Poison Jab, and that's just huge, because now, that was his main, it kind of checked both Rock Polish Bombs. It still would have, like, almost died after Stealth Rock, but it kind of checked them, now it can't. I go into Arceus Ground, and this is Extreme Speed, which is my preferred set right now, just because you can't go wrong with more priority in anything goes. Extreme Speed is, like, the best move, other than Dragon Ascent, because it's fucking Dragon Ascent, what do you want? So he gets his Xerneas in. I was afraid he might predict the Skarmory with Thunder or something, so I'm going to go to Groudon, but no, he just Moonblasts that. And it's really fine, because I can just Rock Polish up, right? And I'm totally safe. I mean, first Moonblast did 33, that one does 31, so I'll probably die, but it's fine, I can just KO this. What ends up actually happening is I miss, because, you know me, I don't hit. But at this point, it's not going to matter too much as long as I can get in my Swords Dance Arceus Ground on what's not a Moonblast. That's what I have to do. So I'm going to go right to Skarmory. I have to roost up a bit first, but as long as I can Toxic and then start stalling this, I'll be fine. I have to roost up one more time, then I can click Toxic, being assured I can take two hits, as he's actually going to switch his Xerneas out, realizing that's kind of futile. Go into his Arceus, as, that's good, because it lets me burn the Lum a little earlier, and if he gets up to plus 6, at that point Shadow Claw will be doing enough to take out Skarmory, and then maybe he can take it back with Scarf Xerne versus Ground Seas, but fortunately, because I do get to burn the Lum early, he's going to get worn down by Toxic, Shadow Claw, or Rocky Helmet, which is activated by Shadow Claw, and it's just not going to be enough. Like, all I have to do is spam Roost. That's not a problem, because he can Swords Dance again, but he'll die to Toxic and Rocky Helmet the next turn, and I can just Roost up to a comfortable amount of health, because, you know, it's Skarmory. It's a kind of dumb mon. Can still do well in Uber, anything goes, another 6 generations, or 5 generations after it's introduced. Anyway, he goes Xerneas, and I am going to leave Skarmory in on what's a really, really telegraphed Thunder. And the reason for that is simply, I could have risked Arceus Ground, and if he clicked Moonblast, I'd lose. And there was no reason to risk that. The only thing that's possibly killing Skarmory is a Thunder. Like, Hidden Power Fire or something weird won't do that. So, I click Roost, and if he doesn't kill me, cool, I can just click Toxic and win. And if he does kill me, then his win chance is now getting a critical hit with Scarf Xerneas, because I can go to Swords Dance Arceus Ground and just Swords Dance and click Earthquake. So, my win chances are basically not getting crit with a Moonblast, and I have lost in this kind of scenario before. I know it's possible, so I kind of had to roll the dice at the end, but fortunately, you know, it's not a very high chance. I don't get critical hit, and that's going to be a very, very close 1-0 versus Rosie Bear. I definitely misplayed a little early, forgetting what sets I had on Arceus and Skarmory, and then coincidentally, I did the same thing in the post-com, but oh well, those are some pretty good Anything Goes games. I do have a lot, and I mean a lot of replays that are pretty good from when I wasn't uploading. I have games versus Kaboom, and Amber Lamps, and Codaval, and Finchinator, and Quite Quiet. So in addition to lives, I'll probably be putting up a lot of post-cons and stuff, but hope you enjoyed some Anything Goes content, because I haven't done enough of that. It's less watched, but I do play a lot of Anything Goes, and I'm having a lot of fun with it. So yeah, I'll see you next time.